The purpose of this video is to instruct you on how to properly power on and off an EpicVue system with domes that are powered with AC power or are plugged into a normal outlet. If your dome serial number begins with the letter S, then this is the right video segment for you. Again, the serial number for your EpicVue dome is located on stickers, both on your dome and on top of your DirecTV receiver. To begin, make sure the truck is parked with an unobstructed view to the southeastern sky. Please note, things like trees, a telephone pole, buildings, your trailer, or other tractors or trailers can block the satellite signal, preventing programming from coming through. If your DirecTV receiver is not receiving programming, please move your truck so that the EpicVue dome has a clear line of sight to the southeastern sky. Plug the TV and DirecTV receiver into a power strip. A power strip is not included with the EpicVue package, and you may need to obtain one on your own. Flip the power strip switch to the on position. Check to make sure the blue light on the front of the receiver is lit. You should also hear the EpicVue dome moving to lock on to the signal. Pictured here is the EpicVue dome power adapter. A coaxial cable from the EpicVue dome connects to the adapter, and from the adapter into the receiver. It also has a power plug to help power the dome. Press the power button, which is located just right of the four lights on the power adapter. When powered on, all four lights will be lit with a solid green light. If there are no lights lit, then press the power button on the adapter again to make sure it is on. Also check to make sure the power cord is properly plugged into the power strip as well as into the adapter. If any of the four lights on the adapter are faint or flickering, the following information describes the purpose of each light, along with some steps to follow to get a solid green light. The first light is the voltage indicator. This light identifies any problems with the power source. If this light is faint or flickering, turn the power button off and secure a better power source. The next light is the receiver indicator light. This light identifies any problems with the coaxial cable connection from the adapter to the receiver. Turn the adapter off and try reconnecting cables. If issue remains, replace the coaxial cable. This light is the dome indicator light. It identifies any problems with the coaxial cable connection from the adapter to the dome. Turn the adapter off and try reconnecting cables. If issue remains, you'll need to have this coaxial cable replaced the next time you return to your terminal. This last light is the power indicator light, and it identifies when the power button is on. Press the power button, which is located to the right of the lights. When pressed, if this light does not go on, then check to make sure the power cord is securely connected to the adapter and the power strip. The receiver usually takes a couple of minutes to turn on and boot up. Once this is done, you should be able to see live programming. If you're not seeing live programming by this point, please refer to the video titled Troubleshooting. A warning before we describe how to power your system down. For stationary systems, before driving, you must always power down the EpicVue dome. Failure to power down the dome while in motion will result in damage to the dome. To turn off your system, push the off button on your DirecTV remote. Turn the EpicVue system off by flipping the power strip switch to the off position. If you don't have a power strip, unplug the receiver. This ensures power is not being sent to the DirecTV receiver, helping to preserve the life of the DVR.